Good morning, students. The laboratory program 9 is based on the singly circular linked list for polynomial expressions. So what we are going to do in the program 9 is we are going to read two polynomial expressions and then we are going to display those two polynomial expressions. We are going to perform the addition of those two polynomial expressions and we are going to finally evaluate the answer, whatever we got in the addition, as evaluation of that particular polynomial expression. Now these polynomial terms, for example, if it is 3x square yz, then these expressions or these terms are stored in the form of node by using the structure singly circular linked list. So before we go into the laboratory program 9, let us see the definition of the singly circular linked list. So just recall the concept of singly linked list. So what was singly linked list made up of? It was actually consisting of data field and as well as next field. So this next field is actually holding nothing but address of the next node. So if you recall the concept, this actually holds the address of the next node. So this has a data field and this actually holds the address of the next node. So this was the concept of singly linked list. So if you go back to the definition over there, in the single linked list, how was the structure actually? It was one data field and which was holding the address of the next field, so like 2, and then again you had 3, and if it was end, we had a null. So here it was actually holding the memory of this, for example 100, 200, 300. So it would hold 100, it would hold 300, that is of next node address. So in a single linked list, for accessing any node of the linked list, we start traversing from the first node. So if you recall the concept, any node, if I want to add, I need to traverse or I need to access, I started from the beginning of the node. Okay, if we are at any node in the middle of the list, for example, I am at this particular node, I cannot traverse back. Okay, if you are at any node in the middle of the list, then it's not possible to access nodes that precedes the given node. That means that is previous of this particular node. I cannot do the traversal. So this was the disadvantage of the single linked list, so which was covered by the singly circular linked list. So what they have done in the singly circular linked list is nothing but whatever this null, it is been replaced back with the memory address of the first node. That is nothing but it is pointing back to the first node. So this problem can be solved by slightly altering the structure of single linked list. In a single linked list, the next part is null. Nothing but here it was actually null. If you utilize this link pointing back to the first node, then you can utilize and you can get access of any node which was in the previous node. For example, if I get back this node over here, I can get any node in between or any node in previous. All these nodes can be accessed. So this concept is nothing but circular single linked list. So in a circular single linked list, the last node of the list contains a pointer to the first node of the list. We can have circular linked list as well as we can also have a circular double linked list, which the concept of double linked list will be explained in the laboratory program 8. So over here it is regarding the circular single linked list. So we traverse a circular single linked list until we reach the same node we started. So what is happening over here? I started from this, I went here, and again back I'm going back to the first node itself. So until there I'm going to do the traversal. So this is the concept of circular single linked list. The operations are same as we have seen in the normal single linked list. We can do the insertion at the beginning, insertion at the end, as well as deletion at the beginning and deletion at the end. Then you can do the searching as well as the traversing over here. So in this concepts, if you want to find the applications of the circular linked list, it's mainly in the used in the maintenance of the operating system. Other than that, you have the examples like browser surfing, where we record a pages visited in the past by the user. So for example, like it is maintained in the form of circular linked list itself, and when you click on the previous button, you get the data back which were accessed previous. For example, you can see in the browser itself, when you click on the back arrow or you go back but again, so which data you had seen previously that can be accessed. So for that also they use the concept of circular single linked list. So this is regarding the definition of circular single linked list. So just difference by single linked list as well as circular linked list is, in single linked list I couldn't access the data of the previous node. Even if I start from the first node itself, it's going right this way. Whereas in the circular linked list, what I made is my last node, whatever was pointing to the null, I made back it to point to the first node so that I can access the previous node. So this is regarding the definition of the circular single linked list. So let us see the demonstration of this program in the next slide regarding the implementation of the program of circular single linked list in the polynomial expression. Lab program 9 is based on design, develop and implement a program in C for the following operations on singly circular linked list with adder nodes. So you know, in the singly circular linked list is nothing but the last node will point back to the head node, that is nothing but the first node. Over here the program is regarding the polynomial. We are evaluating or we are doing the polynomial expression using the singly circular linked list. In this we are going to see the represent and evaluate a polynomial, that is you are going to read the polynomial expression as well as regarding the display, and then you're going to evaluate the polynomial expression, and also you're going to read two polynomials and finding the sum of those two polynomials. So let us give an example of the polynomial expression. Let us consider the polynomial expression one as 3x square yz plus 2x yz plus 1. This is the polynomial 1. Polynomial 2 is 3x square y square z plus 3xyz plus 2. So this is the first polynomial and this is the second polynomial. So what you are supposed to do is you have to read this particular polynomial. While reading, you are just entering the coefficients of these, coefficient of this. For example, this is the first part of the first expression of the polynomial. This entire is a polynomial expression, and that this is the first part. So while reading the polynomial, you're entering the coefficient of this particular as 3, and what are the exponents of x, y, z. So what is the exponent of x over here? 2, and exponent of y is 1, and exponent of z is also 1. So this is how you're going to read the polynomial expression. And again, if you want to continue, yes, you need to type yes, and then again you need to enter the coefficient 2 and the exponents of xyz, that is 2 1 1, and here again 1, and the coefficient of xyz is 0, exponent is 0, exponent of xyz is 0, that is x to the power 0 and y to the power 0 and z to the power 0 will give you 1. So this is how you're going to enter while reading the particular polynomial. Finally, you have to display in this form itself, display the polynomial expression in this form itself. So this is regarding first polynomial, so you need to read and you have to display. Second polynomial also, you're going to read this particular polynomial expression as well as you're going to do the display of the second polynomial expression. Once you're done with this, you need to add these two polynomial expressions. So you remember, while you do the addition of two polynomial, the exponent should be same, then only you can add the two polynomials. For example, your xyz exponent and xyz exponent of these two is same, so you can write directly for add the coefficient, that's it, phi xyz. And here also x to the power, it is actually meaning is x to the power 0, y to the power 0 and z to the power 0, x to the power 0, y to the power 0 and z to the power 0, so plus 3. So this is same, right? That's why we are going to add. Whereas over here x square is there, y square is there, but here y square is missing, so this is in higher form, so you will write directly it as 3x square y square z plus, this is 3x square y z as it is, because we don't have anything x square over here, so it is 3x square y z. So this is, you're reading the first polynomial while by entering the coefficient as well as the exponent, and finally displaying that particular polynomial in this form, and you're reading the second polynomial and displaying the second polynomial, and then you're doing the addition, you got this particular expression, and finally you need to evaluate the result, whatever this result is there, right? That you're going to evaluate. Evaluation is nothing but you're putting the values for the base. Base is nothing but xyz. So you'll take the values, let us take the value x is 1, y is 1 and z is 1. Then you'll get the expression as 3 into 1 into, this will be 1, right? So 3 into that plus 3 plus 5 plus 3. So this would give you 14. This would result in 14. So this is regarding the program regarding the how the polynomial works. This implementation we are showing in the singly circular linked list. I'll repeat the question again. We are going to implement a program in C for the following operation on singly circular linked list with the header nodes. We are going to represent the two polynomial. That means we are reading the polynomial, both the polynomials, and we are displaying the both the polynomials, and then we are performing the addition of those two polynomials, and then finally sum of those two polynomials we are going to perform, and then we are going to do the evaluation of that particular polynomial. So these all operations we are supposed to do in the program 9. So let us go to the implementation part. So we have header files and the structure creation. You know, hash include standard io.h we are going to use for the input output stream, that is scanf and printf. Standard lib is for actually memory allocation. Here we're going to use the malloc function, so we are using standard lib.h. mat.h in case if you're using mathematical functions. Here in this program we have used power, okay, that's why we are going to use the mat.h. Now we need to create a structure for the polynomial, how the polynomial node should appear. So if you had seen our expression, first polynomial expression, we had 3x square yz plus 2xyz plus 1. So this is one form. For this one form, I need to create a structure. So that structure is nothing but node structure. So for this one node, for this one node, and for this one node. So what is all things over there? You have a coefficient over there. You have x to the power 2. Now while I told regarding while you're reading, you're entering the coefficient and the exponent. So what is the exponents you're entering? 2, 1, 1. So exponent of x, exponent of y, exponent of z, as well as you have the link. So this is our node structure for the polynomial for the first part of this particular expression. So for that I need to create a structure. So you know, a structure is nothing but a data type which actually stores a data type of different types. For example, it is nothing but a collection of variables of different types under a single name, that is nothing but the structure. So what is the name of struct I have given over here is struct node. This is the syntax for the struct. It is a keyword, struct keyword. Name is structure, name is node. And what are the fields it should hold? It should hold coefficient and exponents for x, exponent for y, and exponent of z. All these are integers, so I have declared int coefficient, int x, y, z, and then struct node star link. So this you already know, it is a self-referencing structure pointer. Starlink, again, it consists of data part as well as the link part. So this link is nothing but which holds the address of the next field. So here pointer link is defined, so that is nothing but which has a data field and which has a link field. You know, when this link is actually holding address of the next node. For example, if this is 200, this 200 is been hold, and this again has a data part as well as the address link field. So that is regarding the struct node star link, which has a data field and which has a link field. Meaning is nothing but it actually holds the address of the next node. It actually holds the address of next node. So this is regarding struct node. After that, type def struct node star node. So in this type def struct node star node is nothing but type def is used to give an aliasing name for the structure. We are going to give a different name for this particular structure. So that name is nothing but node. And why I am writing that star node? Because you know it has a data part as well as the link part. So this link part actually holds address. That's why we are going to name it as pointer node. So type def struct node is nothing but it creates an alias name for the structure, that is declaring some new name for the structure. So this is regarding the type def struct node star node. So this is regarding the header files and structure creation of polynomial node. The next is regarding function to create a node. So you know, in the node section I have a coefficient and exponent for x and exponent for y and exponent for z, and then I have a link, and that link is, you know, in this circular the link is pointing self to its back to head. For example, if we don't have any other nodes, then it is back pointing to this itself, under itself. So over here, node get node node X, for these, I need to allocate the memory allocation. That means whatever the size of this coefficient and exponent of XYZ as well as the link, so much memory should be allocated. So that is done by malloc function by finding the size of struct node. So you know, for these all are four are integer types. And then this is of a node structure. Again, it occupies 8 bytes, link pointer. So total memory allocation is done to this. Size of struct is nothing but total memory allocation. Okay. So whatever they occupied by the node is being allocated, and that is being typecasted to again node structure. So that is being again typecasted to the node structure, and that is stored in X. And finally, you are going to return X. If you see the single linked list, we had written X link is equal to null. Whereas over here, we are not going to refer X link is equal to null. Nowhere the link will be null because it is back pointing to the header, since it is circular linked list. So this is regarding how to create a node. So this is regarding function to create a node. Next is function to read a polynomial. So before we read a polynomial, let us take a polynomial expression. First polynomial expression, what was there? So let me write over here. It is nothing but 3x square yz plus 2xyz. 2xyz plus 1. So this is my polynomial, first polynomial expression. Similarly, same function is used to read the second polynomial expression. I'll just show the implementation of first polynomial expression. So in the node read poly, you have node temp and head and the current. So these are the nodes I'm actually going to use over there. These are the nodes actually I'm supposed to use in this particular program. So I'm creating node temp, head and current, and cache is to read whether I want to continue to read the next expression. First I'll read only this particular node, second is this, third is this. So if I want to continue, that's why I'm using this cache ch. Okay, first head is equal to get node. So you know, head is equal to get node means it will go back to this and it will create this particular node with certain memory allocation of this particular struct node. Okay, so head is equal to get node means this is been created with the coefficient and with X exponent, Y exponent and Z exponent and link back to this particular this itself. If you remember, in this particular head is equal to get node means creates a head node, and he has told head coefficient as -1. So coefficient initially is -1, X also is -1, exponent is also of Y is also -1, Z is also -1, and head link is pointing back to head itself. Let the memory address be 100, so let it be pointing back to the 100 itself. So this is my head. So this is the head. So here you might have seen node head I'm going to use. Temp is when I read this, right? That time I'll be using that temp node, and current is to point initially over here and start from the initially from here. I'm start tracing the addition of the particular node. So I've created node temp, head, current, cache. I'll tell where I'm using. Initially I got head is equal to get node, and I set all the values equal to -1. So that this entire section is this particular node I've set. After that, do while loop. Okay, so do while loop means it will go within the do, and then temp is equal to get node. Temp is equal to get node. So let the temp is equal to get node means, you know, again a coefficient part is being created. This is for the coefficient, and then again X exponent, Y exponent, Z exponent, and this is X, this is Y, and this is Z exponent, and then you have the link. Okay, then you have the link. So this is nothing but temp. So this is our temp. Okay, so temp is equal to get node, just this node structure is being created. Enter the coefficient and exponents in the decreasing order. Enter the coefficients and exponents in the decreasing order. Okay, so this have to enter. So this I'm supposed to enter, that is, so I need to enter 3. And whatever the exponent of X is 1. So what I'm supposed to enter is 3, 2, exponent of X is 2, and 1, 1. So actually here it will be 3, 2, 1 of Y and 1 of Z. And this I'll let you know what we are going to do. So what I'm doing is enter the coefficient and exponent in decreasing order. So from decreasing order I'm going to enter. Okay, so scanf percentage D, percentage D, percentage D, percentage D. Actually what it is reading is 3 and 3 exponents, or exponent of X is 2, exponent of this is 1, and this is also 1. So percentage D, percentage D, percentage D, percentage D, and temp coefficient. Coefficient is 3, and temp of X is 2, and temp of Y is 1 and temp of z is 1. Okay, so it has been read. Next, current is equal to head. Current is equal to head. What is the memory address of head? Is 100. So current is equal to head means current is also pointing over here. Current is also pointing over here. Here you have read and kept in the temp. Temp, you have just read this particular node and read. Remember, whatever you entered is not the coefficient of x value, not the values of x. You have entered the exponents of x in this. Don't get confused. You have not added the values of x. Instead, you have added the exponents of x. Okay, so temp of x, temp of y, temp of z is been read. Current is equal to head. Now you'll come to the while loop. While current link not equal to head, but here, what is the current link again pointing back to the head? So while current link not equal to head, what is there in current link actually? 100. What is there in head? 100. Head memory address is 100. Current link memory address is also 100. Whether they both are not equal, they are actually equal. So this statement fails for the first iteration. So this line will not work. It will come to this particular. So within this, you have just this single statement. Okay, within this while loop, you have just this single statement. So current link equal to temp. So this will not work. It will come out of this loop. It will come and update over here. Current link equal to temp. Current link equal to temp means what? Let the memory address of this be 200. Current link means current is over here. Here it will be updated to 200. If this is updated to 200, automatically the connection should be built. And nowhere this connection will be there. This will be erased. Nowhere it is pointing to the head. Nowhere it is pointing. Now current link is equal to temp means what? What is the memory address of temp? It is 200. That 200 will be passed over here, current link. Okay, after that, this is temp, right? Temp link is equal to head. Now see, since it is a, you just told current is been, this node should be attached to this. So where I have to place for this memory address? Head should be always here. I cannot update every time to the next. Why I'm using current is so that I can move on to the next node. Head will be always the first one, so that's why I'm using current. So current link is equal to temp means 200. So what it will be, this 200 will be stored over here. Okay, after that, what about this link? It is a circular, right? So this link should point back to over here. So what memory address should be there of head, right? So temp link should hold the address of head. So that is 100. Temp link here, 100 should be stored, and that is back connected to this. Okay, so this is how you're going to add. So I'll just repeat. While current link not equal to head, it became false because initially it was 100 and 100, so this statement did not work. Current link is equal to temp. What I did, this link I connected to temp node, so obviously memory address will be stored, and this should be connected back to this. So temp link should hold the memory address of the head. So I've updated over here, temp link is equal to head. Next, do you want to enter more coefficient? If you don't want to enter more coefficient, you can give n. Since our expression has again two terms, I'll give s over here. F flush is nothing but to clear the buffer, to clear the previous values, or to clear the standard in buffer. And after that, it has been read percentage c and ch. I gave yes. When I give s again, it will go to the temp is equal to get node. Again, it will come back to this temp, when, because while ch is equal to s, if I give, it will come to the again do temp is equal to get node. So again, temp is equal to get node is being created over here. Temp is equal to get node, node is being created. So what are the fields? You actually second node, right? So second node I'm going to read. So it is 2, x exponent is 1, y exponent is 1, z exponent is also 1. So I'll give 2 1 1 2 1 1, and then I have this particular node. Okay, sorry, then I have a link over there, sorry, 2 1 1, and then here it is for the link. Okay, 2 1 1, and then link. So here temp is equal to get node. It is just created get node without any values. It just got, and the coefficient and exponents in the decreasing order. So in the second iteration, what I'll do, I'll enter 2 1 1 1. So these all fields will be entered. Initially, when temp is equal to get node, just memory is being allocated and blank over here. I have read it over here, %d for coefficient, and these 3% d for the exponents of x, y and z. So 2 1 1 is read. Now current is equal to head. That means again current is over here, current is equal to head. While current link not equal to head, so in the second iteration, check where is current link, whether it is equal to head. No, current link, current is this, that link is actually pointing to the next node. So while current link is not equal to head, what is there in current link? It is 200. What is there in head? Head is 100. So 200 not equal to 100 is true. If it is so, current is equal to current link. What is there in current link? Current is equal to 200. So current will point over here. Now updated current value is 200. Again it will come back to the while loop. So while here it will check current link not equal to head. What is in the current link? Again it will come to the while loop. What is there in the current link now? Current link, you updated current link is this. So it is 100 not equal to 100. So this will be false. So it will not execute this while loop. It will come over here. Now current is over here. Current link equal to temp. Whatever this you have read, right? For that it is equal. Current link is equal to temp. So current link equal to temp means what will happen? This will be no longer 100. Current link is equal to temp means it will be no longer 100. Instead it will be updated to 300. It will be updated to 300. Is it got? And this is how you're going to connect. When it is 300, then obviously the link is created. Now this is your temp, right? Recently read temp is this. What we have to do, since it is circular, again we need to back connect it to head. So again temp link is equal to head. So it here will be updated 100. No longer this will be there. No longer this will be there. So that is regarding your updated to here it is 100 again. That so your same thing, current link is equal to temp means current link is 300, temp means this 300, and temp link is equal to 100, head means what is that? Temp link is what? Temp is this, so that should be again pointing to head, so it should store the address of 100. So this is how I read the second node. Similarly, again, do you want to enter more coefficient? I'll give yes. I'll give yes because I have to read this coefficient also, 1 1. So again it will come over, temp is equal to get node. Temp is equal to get node. So what is the get node? You know it has for the coefficient x, y and z, and for the link. So in the decreasing order, so in the third iteration I'll give coefficient as 1 because it's only 1. And what is the base, I mean exponents of x, y, z? It is actually 0. So you give 1 0 0 and 0. 1 0 and 0, and then I've just read it and kept. Current is equal to head. Again current will be over here. Current is pointing back to this. Current is equal to head. Current is equal to head. So I'll erase just these sections now. All right, so I'll show over here. Current is equal to head, right? I'll show in this particular section. Current is equal to head. So current, this iteration I'll be showing over here. So current is going pointing over here and head is equal to here. So current will be equal to 100. Memory address is 100. After that, while current link, what is current link now? 100's link. That is current link is having while 200 not equal to head. 100. Yes, it is true, right? Now current link is 200. That is not equal to head. That is 100. Yes, it is not equal to head. It is 100. When it is in that case, what you're supposed to do is current is equal to current link. Current is equal to current link. So what is there in current? Current will be equal to current link. Current link is equal to 200. Current is equal to 200. So current will be pointing over here. So your current will be pointing now. Again it will come back to the while loop again. So again it will check while current link 300. Current link is 300 not equal to 100. Yes, this is also true. If it is true, current is equal to current link. Current is equal to current link. That means current will be pointing over here. Current will be pointing over here. Now updated. So that is nothing but 300. Current is equal to 300. Yes. Now again it will come back over here. Again while loop it will go. So what is there in current link now? 300's link. It is 100. While 100 not equal to 100. This is false. So when it is false, this statement won't execute. This statement won't execute. So it will come directly over here. For this you have to connect to this particular node, right? So it will tell current link is equal to 10. This is your recent temp, right? So current link is equal to 10. Assume 400 is your memory address. So this has to be connected. This has to be connected, and this should hold the memory address of your first one. So this will be no longer link will be from here to here. So this is regarding how we are going to read. So again, current from here to here, current link is equal to 10. That means temp memory address is 400. This statement, current link is equal to means temp is equal to 400, and temp's link should again be pointed to head. Why? Because it is circular. So here we are storing 100. So temp's link should hold the memory address of head. So So temp link should hold the memory address of end head. So we have read this particular polynomial expression. After that, do you want to enter more coefficient? I'll give no. When it is no, it will come out of the loop. So this is the thing how you're going to read the particular polynomial expression. So this is the function to read the polynomial expression. Similarly, you're also going to read the second polynomial expression, that is 3x square y square z plus 3xyz plus 2. In similar same function, we are going to use this particular polynomial. So I've just shown with reading the first polynomial. Same way we are going to do the reading process of the second polynomial. Let us go to the display the polynomial expression. So let us have the node structure what we had over there. We had minus 1, minus 1 for x, minus 1 for y, minus 1 for z, and then we had link. So in that, within that link, we had 3, 2, 1, 1, and then again we had 2, 1, 1, 1, this, and then again we have 1, 0, 0, 0, and then again. This was pointing back to this particular node. So this is head, and this was my current. If you imagine, this was my current. Okay, and yeah, this was the, and for example, memory address was 100. I have just written 200, 300, 400. This was holding 100, and this was holding 400, and this is 300, and this is 200. So this was my node structure. I'm just showing regarding the first polynomial display. First poly. Similarly for the second poly also. So void print node pointer, node current. So current is pointing, head is pointing. Current is equal to point, again here, pointer is also from the beginning itself. So both these node PTR is there, right? That is also pointing from the beginning itself. So head, current, PTR, all these are pointing to the this particular node. So node current are defined with this. Current is equal to pointer link. So it will be, current is equal to pointer link means what? PTR is here. What is PTR link? You have 200. So current will be updated to this CUR, current. While current not equal to PTR, what is there in while current? What is your current value? Now current is 200, right? 200, current is pointing over here. While 200 is not equal to PTR, PTR is 100, pointer node value, memory address is 100. While current is not equal to PTR, you need to print from this section, right? From this polynomial. How, what is the display of this? Finally, you should get the display as 3x square yz plus 2xyz plus 1. This is how you're going to get the display of the polynomial expression. So we'll check, while 200 not equal to 100, it is true. If it is so, print percentage d. That means what? Percentage d is of coefficient, that coefficient, and then x power percentage d of this. So that is nothing but x square y z. That is, this is for the coefficient, then x exponent, that was 2, and y exponent was 1, and z exponent is 1. So current coefficient, whatever this current coefficient, current x, current y, current z will be printf. That means this expression will be printed in this particular statement. In this particular statement, after that, current is updated to current link. Current is updated to current link means what? Current is equal to current link means 300. So current will be updated over here. Sorry, current is over here. After that, if current is not equal to PTR, current is this. If current is what now? 300. If that is not equal to 100, yes, it is true. If it is true, just print plus. So after this, now plus will be printed. After this, now just this will be printed, 3x square yz plus. So that is done. Again, it will go to this while current not equal to PTR. Now your current in the second iteration, current is 300. Current was pointing here, right? 300 not equal to 100 in the second iteration. After that, print same thing, print whatever is there in this particular node. So it will print nothing but 2xyz, and then again you'll check if current, okay, yeah, it will print 2xyz, and current is equal to current link. So updated current will be this. Now if current is 400, if 400 is not equal to 100 PTR, 100, yes, is it is true, then again print plus. So previous iteration I got 3xyz plus, now I got 2xyz sorry, 3x square yz plus 2xyz plus gets printed. Now again it will go to the third iteration. In the third iteration, what it would be? While current not equal to PTR, what is your current? 400. While 400 not equal to 100. Yes, it is true. If it is true, printf of this particular current node. So what it would print? Percentage d. Percentage d is coefficient 1 and x to the power 0 is 1 itself. So here it is nothing but 1 0 0 0. So that is, you're going to print it out. So it will print actually 1 and current will be updated to current link. So now in this iteration, current is pointing over here. Okay, 1 will be printed. So here plus 1 will be printed. Now you check if current not equal to PTR. What is current now? Current is also 100 and PTR is also 100. Whether it is true? No, it is false. So this will be not printed. Again, it will come while current not equal to PTR. So false. Again, while loop also gets false. Why? Because 100 not equal to 100 is false. So this is the end of that particular display. So this is how it will display that particular polynomial. So this is regarding the first polynomial display. So I hope it's clear with the read polynomial as well as regarding the display. Let us see the main function over here. So in the main function void main, I need a ch to read the, to scan the options, and then I created node ABC. So while one infinite loop, I am going to represent the first polynomial. So this is nothing but to read the polynomial A. Read the polynomial A. This is to the read polynomial B. This is to display polynomial A. And this is to display polynomial B. And this is to add these two polynomial and finally evaluate. So there are totally 6 cases with, again, including with exit. Enter any of your choices. So switch choice, if you go, it will go to the enter the elements of the polynomial. So when they enter the elements of the polynomial, A is equal to read polynomials. For example, if you remember that equation 3x square yz plus 2xyz plus 1, here you need to enter the elements of those polynomials. So that would take, actually when you go to the read poly, it will take 3 2 1 1. So this is how you're going to read that polynomial. If you remember here, it will go to this particular read poly function and it will read these things. So this is regarding the read poly. And then again, first polynomial you're going to read, second polynomial so you're going to read. So whatever, if you remember, that was 3x square y square z plus 3xyz plus 2, that you're going to do in the read. And display of this particular two polynomials is for this print and p. And regarding add poly and addition of these two polynomials, and regarding evaluate, that what I've shown in the question, add polynomial and evaluate, if you remember, I've shown over here, this is what you're supposed to get for the addition of the two polynomials, and this is the answer you're supposed to get for the evaluate of the two polynomials. So regarding the addition of the polynomials and the evaluation of the polynomial, I'll explain it in the polynomial second session, as well as regarding the execution in the code blocks. So this is, in this section we had seen how to create a node, how the structure is being created, how you're going to read the polynomial, as well as how you're going to display the polynomial, and then regarding the main function. In the next session we'll be seeing regarding the evaluation and the addition of two polynomials. Thank you.